Good morning students, today we are going to see the value and the zeros of a polynomial, right? In the previous period we have learned about the whole introduction part of what is the polynomial, types of polynomial, okay, how we can understand the given polynomial is polynomial in one variable or polynomial in two variable, what is the degree, what is the coefficient of each term, everything means what are the basics about the polynomial we have learned. Now today in this lecture we will see what is the value of the polynomial and the zeros of the polynomial. So generally we have shown any polynomial with p of x, f of x, okay, so like this. So polynomials in which two terms are there, three terms are there, more than three terms are there, right? So any polynomial can be represented in the form of p of x. So the value of a polynomial p of x at x equals to suppose to be a means here a means we can take the any value of x. So we have to find the value of polynomial p of x at x equals to a is that we have to find out, that is p of a. P of a means we have to find the value of p of x at x equals to a means we have to replace the x by a. Okay, so suppose to be here any of the number is given and then we have to find the value of given p of x. Given p of x means given polynomial at the value of x equals to a. So in that polynomial we have to replace x by a. Okay, so that we will see with the help of example. For example, suppose to be the p of x equals to x square plus 2x plus 3. This is your polynomial. That polynomial we can represent by p of x. Okay, so p of x, why we will write only x here? Because your polynomial in which variable? X variable. Okay, so p of x equals to x square plus 2x plus 3. Then we have to find the value of this p of x at x equals to 2. So what will be the value of p of x at x equals to 2? That now we will see. Okay, so here we have to replace the value of x here. We have to replace this x by 2. Okay, so here like this, x equals to a. A is the any number we can take. So here we have to find the value of given polynomial at x equals to 2. So here we have to replace this x by 2. So p of 2 equals to x square means what will be there? X square instead of there 2. So we will write here 2 square plus 2 into 2 plus 3. Right? So here 2 square is 4 plus 2 2's are 4 plus 3. So you will get 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 3, 11. So here we can write p of 2 equals to you got 11. So it is 11 is the value of your given polynomial p of x equals to x square plus 2x plus 3 at x equals to 2. So simply these examples in that we can take any values of this x equals to 2 instead of 2. We can take x equals to 0, x equals to minus 1 or any given values of x. Okay, so first we will find here p of supposed to be 0, we will find out, right? We will find out p of minus 1. And that means here x equals to 0 is what we will give. Here x equals to 0 and here they will give here x equals to supposed to be minus 1. So we have to find the values of given polynomial. So here p of x equals to your polynomial x square plus 2x plus 3. So which value we will take here? X equals to 0. So p of 0 equals to 0 square plus 2 into 0 plus 3. Okay, so here 0 square is 0 only, plus 2 zeros are 0 plus 3. So 0 plus 0 plus 3 is 3. So you will get p of 0 equals to 3. So this is the value of your given polynomial at x equals to 0. Understood everyone? Now here we will take that minus 1, x equals to minus 1 value is given, then we have to find the value of given polynomial at x equals to minus 1. So your polynomial is p of x equals to x squared plus 2x plus 3, that is x squared with 2 square. Here we will replace this with x with minus 1. So minus 1 square plus 2 into minus 1 plus 3. So any negative number having the square is always positive. So here 1 square is 1. This plus minus will come. Minus 2 ones are 2 plus 3. Okay. So here 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2 is your minus 1. Minus 1 plus 3. So you will get here minus plus minus. So you will get 2. So what is the value of p of x at x equals to minus 1? That is 2. Understood everyone? Now like this we will see the more examples on the value of polynomial. Okay. Okay. Now here find p of 0, p of 1 and p of 2 for a polynomial. P of t equals to 2 plus t plus 2t square minus t cube. Now this polynomial is like this, many polynomials we can take to find out the values of that polynomial for the p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, p of minus 2, 4, p of 4, like this. We can take here many of the polynomial code. Okay, so for this polynomial we will find the value of polynomial at p of 0, p of 1 and p of 2. Okay, so how to solve this? So your polynomial is p of t equals to 2 plus t plus 2t square minus t cube. Now this, in this polynomial which one variable is used? T variable, right? So polynomial in which variable? P of t is in a t variable, right? So we have to replace this t by first p of 0. Okay, so first we will find for this p of 0. Means we have to replace this value of t with 0. So you will get here p of, instead of t what we will use? 0, right? So p of 0 equals to 2 becomes this 2 plus what is the value of t? It is 0. Okay, plus 2 into 0, that 0 square is 0 only, right? So if you not write this, there is no problem, right? Minus t cube means what? 0 cube. So we have to write in this form. Okay, so here this 2 becomes 2 plus 0 into relatively, then 2 into 0 square, then you will get the 0 value and this is 0 only. Okay, so 0, 0 and 0. So you will get only 2 plus 0, it is 2. So p of 0, what is the value of given polynomial at p of 0 is 2. Understood everyone? Now you will see what is the value of given polynomial at p of 1. Okay, so p of t, you will write your polynomial 2 plus t plus 2t square minus t cube. So what is given t value? It is p of 1 means 1 is there. Okay. So 2 plus 1 plus 2 into 1 square minus 1 cube. Okay. So here 2 plus 1, that is 3, plus 2 into 1 square, it is 1. So 2 ones are 2 minus 1 cube is what? 1. So 3 plus 2, 5. 5 minus 1, 4. You will get answer is 4. Understood? So similarly, we will find out the p of, what is the value of given polynomial for the p of 2. So here directly I will write now p of 2. Right? So what is the polynomial here? This 2 plus t. T means what? What is the value of t? It is 2. So 2 plus 2, then plus 2 into what is the value of t, that is 2 square minus 2 cube. Understood? So now here 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2 into what is the 2 square? 2 square it is 4 minus 2 cube is what? 2 cube, not we cannot say 2, 3 is 6. 2 cube means 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. Okay? So here this 4, this plus 4 to the 8 and this minus 8. So this plus minus 8 will get cancelled. So you will get value of P of t at the 0 and 2, you will get value is 4. So these are called the values of given polynomial at the given values, means 0, 1, 2. Okay. So like this, we can take these also values, we can change the values and we can change the again the polynomials form. Okay. So P of x equals to something different polynomial, like this means we can use the meaning polynomial. Understood? Now we will see next, it is zeros of a polynomial. Okay. So for example, any polynomial is given, that is the P of x. So when we can say that a is the zero of a polynomial, when you will replace the x by a, and if you will get the value of polynomial is 0. Okay, after replacing the x by a, when you will get P of a equals to 0, then that value of a is called the zero of a polynomial. Understood? For example, supposed to be your polynomial, any polynomial, that we can say a is 0 of a polynomial when P of a equals to 0 will be there. Okay, or we can say that P of x at x equals to a, then P of a, when you will get means we have to replace x by a, then if P of a you are getting 0, then we can say that a is, means the value of a, whatever it is given, that a is the 0 of a polynomial. Understood? Now we will see with the help of example. So here we will consider one of the example, P of x equals to this polynomial 4x cube minus 3x square minus 6x plus 32. Okay, in this example we don't have given the any values of x. Okay, so that from that we can say whether that value is the zero of the polynomial x or no. Okay, so first in this example we will try to find out what will be the zero of this given polynomial. Okay, so first we will replace this x by 0 for it. For example, this P of 0, we will find out the P of 0, what is the value of this given polynomial at x equals to 0. Okay, so 4 into 0 cube minus 3 into 0 square minus 6 into 0 plus 32. Okay, so here you will get this 4 into 0 cube, this will come 0 only. So 4 into 0, 0. Here minus this 3 into 0 square, that 0 square, that 0. So 3 into 0, that is 0. Minus here also you will get 0 plus 32. So finally you got here 32. So what is the P of 0? P of 0, it is 32. That 32 is the value of this given polynomial. Okay, this 32 is, we can say that this is the value of your given polynomial at x equals to 0. Similarly, we will find out supposed to be P of minus 1. I will take that x equals to minus 1. So P of minus 1 equals to 4 into minus 1 minus 3 into minus 1 square minus 6 into minus 1 plus 32. Okay. So here 4 into any negative number, this 4 into any negative number having the cube. Means here exponent is even or odd? Of course odd. So any negative number having exponent is odd, then your final answer is negative. Okay, so you will get here minus 1. Okay, minus these 3, if any negative number having the square is always positive. So 1 square is 1 will be there. Then here minus 6 into minus 1. So you will get minus 6 plus 32. Okay, so here this 4 into minus 1, you will get minus 4. This minus 3, then minus minus, plus 6, plus 32. So here, this minus minus number we can add. So here minus 7, plus 6, plus 32. So you will get here answer is minus 1, plus 32. 32 minus 1, you will get 31. Okay, so this is the value of your given polynomial. What is the value we got? 31. 31 is the value of given polynomial at p of minus 1, means x equals to minus 1. So again, so we cannot see it is the 0 of the polynomial. Here also we cannot see it is the 0 of the polynomial because we got the sum values after replacing x values, this and this, right? So we want value of, after replacing any value of x that we want 0, then only we can say that that value is the 0 of a polynomial. Okay, so here we will try for this p of supposed to be minus 2. Okay, p of minus 2 equals to put it here, p of minus 2. So we will replace the value of x with minus 2 into the given polynomial, and whether we can check here, we will check here the value is 0, we are getting yes or no. Okay, so here your polynomial is 4x cube, means 4 into what is the x value? Minus 2. So minus 2 cube. Okay, then minus 3 into x square, means what? Minus 2 square, right? Then minus 6 into minus 2 plus 32. This is the problem. Here, once again to see here, 4 into x cube. X cube means here, x cube is there. So, what is the value of x? We have select here minus 2. So, 4 into minus 2 cube minus 3 into x square. It is x square. So, we can take here minus 2 square minus 6 into x value is minus 2 plus 32. Okay. So now here 4 into what is the minus 2 cube? 2 cube is 8. So you will get here 4 into minus 8. Right? Minus 3 into minus 2 square is, of course it is positive number, you will get 4. 2 square is 4. And here this minus minus will come plus. So plus 6 2s are 12 plus 32. Understood everyone? Now here 8 4s are 32. So you will get negative sign is here. So minus 32. Right? Plus, plus minus. Sorry, here you will get minus. 4 3s are 12. So minus 12 plus 32. Now see here, no minus 12 plus 12 will get cancelled. Then minus 32 plus 32 you will get cancelled. So you got the value is 0 here. Okay. So for which value of x in the given polynomial you got the value is 0? Yes. Yes, of course, minus 2. So here you got p of minus 2 equals to 0. P of minus 2 equals to 0. What is the value of polynomial you got? 0. So the minus 2 is the 0 of your given polynomial. Understood everyone? So here minus 2 is a 0 of a polynomial. Understood everyone? Here if you will see here p of minus 1 you got 31. Here p of 0 you got 32. Of course all are these are the values of your given polynomial. But when the values of the given polynomial you got the 0, then that in that we can say that is for which value of x you got the value of given polynomial is 0. For that value we can say it is the zeros of your polynomial. It is 0 of your polynomial. Understood everyone? Not here. P of 0 is the 0 of the polynomial? No. P of minus 1 is the 0 of the polynomial? No. P of minus 2 is the 0 of the polynomial? Yes. Why? Because we got the value of polynomial is 0. So, minus 2 is the 0 of polynomial. Understood? Now we will see two more examples on this. Okay, here find the 0 of a given polynomial. So, in these examples, we will find directly how to find the zeros of the polynomial. In the previous example, we have find the zeros of the given polynomial by putting 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 3, like this, 0 also, right? And for which value you are getting whole the polynomial value is 0, that is the 0 of the polynomial. It's just like the trial and error method. Trial method like this. Okay, so here in these examples we can directly find what is the value of the zero, what is the zero of the given polynomial, right? So zero of the given polynomial means this value you will get zero, right? So we have to take this value with equals to zero. So for p of x equals to 3x minus 21 we have to find the 0 of this given polynomial. So, p 3x minus 21 we have to equate with 0. Means whatever you will keep the value of x here, then you will get whole value of this term is 0. Okay, so for to find the direct what is the value of x will be there, for that you will get 0, you have to use this method. Okay, so 3x minus 21 equals to 0. So you know that we have learned this type of examples into the which topic, equations. Okay, so now here 3x minus 21 equals to 0, so minus 21 we will shift to this side. Okay, so minus 21 will go there, then it becomes plus 21. So 3x equals to, you will get 21. Okay, now we have to find the value of actually x here. Okay, so x equals to 21. This 3 is multiplied here. Here will come for divide. So x 21 upon 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 sevens are 21. So x equals to 7. Now this x equals to 7. X equals to 7 is means here 7 is a 0 of given polynomial. Now how it is the 7 is the 0 of the polynomial, we will check here. Okay, see p of 7 if you will keep here. What is the x value? 7. If you keep here p of 7. So equals to 3 into what is the value of x? We have to take 7 minus 21. Okay, so 7 threes are 21 minus 21, so you will get 0. Understood? So directly here we can find the what is the 0 of your given polynomial, because here x is the x equals to 7, so 7 is the 0 of the polynomial. Why? Because x, after putting the value of x, you are getting the value of given polynomial is 0. Understood? So next example we will take p of x equals to 5. So now what you will do here? Yes, 5x equals to 0. Okay, so x equals to 0 by 5. So you will get x equals to what? 0. See here, if you will put here x value is 0, then 5 into 0, that is 5 0 0, so you are getting p of x equals to 0 at x equals to 0. Understood everyone? So this is 0 is called the 0 of your given polynomial. Understood? Now we will see the next example. P of x equals to px plus q. What you will do here? This px plus q you have to equate with 0. So px plus q equals to 0. Okay? Which value we have to find? X value. So we cannot replace this. So we have to replace this plus q. We will send to this side. So 0 here, px equals to 0 minus q. So px equals to 0 minus q means q is the any number. So you will get only minus q. Okay, now we have to find the value of x. So x equals to minus q by p. So this minus q by p minus q by p is 0 of a given polynomial. Understood now? Maybe verify whether it is 0 of the polynomial x or no, or why we can say minus q by p is the 0 of this given polynomial. Okay, so we will put here the value of x. So p of x, what is the value of x here? Minus q by p. Okay, minus q by p, okay, is equals to p into x value we have to keep, minus q by p. Okay, then plus q. Understood everyone? Now here this p get cancelled, so you will get minus q plus q. So plus minus minus, so this will get cancelled, so you will get 0. And so that we can say that minus q by p is a 0 of a polynomial. Understood everyone? Okay, on this topics, values and the zeros of the polynomial, we will see one more type of example. Verify whether the values following are the zeros of the polynomial indicated against them. Okay, means one of the polynomials are given, against that the values of x are given here. We have to check whether if that values are the zeros of the polynomial, yes or no, that we have to check. Okay, so here for this polynomial p of x equals to 3x square minus 1. For the verification, the two values of x are given. X equals to what? Minus 1 by root 3, and another value of x is given, 2 by root 3. Right? So first we will use minus 1 by root 3. Whether we have to check it is the 0 of the polynomial, yes or no. Okay. So here we will replace this x value with what? X equals to minus 1 by root 3. Minus 1 by root 3. Understood what we have to do for this example? Okay. So here 3 into x value is minus 1 by root 3 bracket square minus 1. Okay. This minus 1. So here 3 multiplied by minus 1. This negative number having square is positive. So you will get 1, and root 3 square, any root square number square is that number itself. So it is 3 and this is minus 1. So 3 ones are, it get cancelled. So this, what is the remaining in this? Only 1. So 1 minus 1, so 1 minus 1 equals to 0. So here we have verified whether this the value of this x, that is minus 1 by root 3, is the 0 of the polynomial, because after putting these values of x and when you simplify this polynomial you got 0. So we can say that what? Minus 1 by root 3 is a 0 of given polynomial. Okay, so here for this example only, we will take the next value, x is 2 by root 3. So here p of 2 by root 3 equals to what is your polynomial 3 into x square. X square means root square 2 by root 3 bracket square. Understood? Minus 1. Then here 3 this remains as it is. 2 square is 4. Root 3 square is 3. Right? Minus 1. So this 3, 3 will get cancelled. So 4 minus 3. Sorry. 4 minus 1. So 4 minus 1 is 3. Okay. So you got here when P of 2 by root 3 you got the values of this given polynomial and this x value is 3. So is it this 0 is the 0 of the polynomial? No. So we can write here 2 by root 3 is not a 0 of given polynomial. Understood everyone? So like this we have to check whether it is the given values against the given polynomial are the zeros of the polynomial. Like this we have to verify. So first one value minus 1 by root 3. After putting you are getting 0. So it is called minus 1 by root 3 is the 0 of the polynomial. But when you will put the same for the same value or same polynomial 2 by root 3 value. So you are getting the values, some values of this polynomial now other than 0. So means 2, 3, minus 1, like any positive or negative value. Okay, negative number. So that we can say that it is not a 0 of a polynomial. Understood? So one more last example you will see here. P of x equals to Lx plus n, where we have to check whether for this value x equals to minus m by n. Okay, so here P of x value is minus n by n here, so equals to n multiplied by what is the x value? Minus n by n. Okay, plus n. So here n multiplied by minus n by n. If you write this n, n will get cancelled and this plus m, so minus m plus m you are getting 0. So whether it is x equals to minus m by n is the 0 of the polynomial? Yes, of course. Why? Because we are getting the value is 0. Okay, so we will write here what minus m by n is a 0 of given polynomial. Understood everyone?